I speak to you in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The first Palm Sunday was an exciting day. It was exciting because the King was coming to his people in their main city of Jerusalem. The people were so thrilled that they took off their cloaks and spread them on the road on which the King would travel. Other folks cut branches from trees and spread them on the road. The people were shouting and cheering because their prophesied King was coming to them. But he was coming to them in a way they were not expecting. He was coming to them in a way they were not expecting. He was coming on a donkey. And as you and I know, kings do not ride donkeys. Kings ride horses. So it would have been strange for the people to see Jesus riding into Jerusalem on a donkey. But they were still excited and celebratory. And this King did not come in a majestic way. He came in humility. He came in meekness. He came in peace. And that's what the donkey on which Jesus rode represents. It represents humility and peace, rather than a horse that shows power and position, strength and authority. Jesus did not come to his people in the way they wanted or expected. The people were expecting their Messiah to deliver them from Roman domination and self-serving religious authorities, bringing Jerusalem and all of Israel back to its former glory. They were hoping that the Messiah would restore them to their own sovereignty. And so they cheered as their Savior came. They proclaimed him as the King, the Son of David, the long-awaited Messiah. Hosanna to the Son of David. The blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. And shouting the word Hosanna would have been appropriate, for it is a unique Aramaic word meaning please save us or please help us. So the people were shouting for their Messiah to save them, for their Messiah to help them. And Jesus would have come toward the edge of the Kidron Valley, passing by the Mount of Olives, where there's a major graveyard. And the Jews believe that when the Messiah comes, he will come from the Mount of Olives and enter through the beautiful gate victoriously. However, what is ironic is the Messiah did come from the Mount of Olives, but the religious leaders didn't recognize him. And when the crowd said, it's the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee, the religious leaders didn't expect a prophet to come from Nazareth or Galilee, and certainly not the Messiah. After all, we are told, can anything good come out of Nazareth? So rather than being a mighty warrior king, the people hoped for, Jesus was a king riding on a young donkey, who brings peace, not only to them, but to all nations. And it was the fulfillment of the scriptures. The prophet Zechariah had outlined in chapter 9 and verse 9, the kind of Messiah Jesus was going to be. For he writes, rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout out, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you, triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. And by riding on a donkey, Jesus was declaring he was indeed the Messiah, the Christ, the King. And they just weren't expecting a Messiah like him. But the people gathered for the Passover celebration should have known this, for this had been prophesied for centuries. And they would have realized that this action by Jesus was a fulfillment of the prophecy, and that he was not going to be an earthly king, but a king who will reign in God's plan of love and grace, forgiveness and salvation, joy and peace. This was the kind of Messiah that was coming to the people. However, the people who shouted, "Hosanna, please save us, please help us," were thinking about him saving us or saving them from foreign domination. But Jesus came to save them and us from our sins. My friends, Jesus comes to us, but more often, not in the way we expect. Jesus comes to us, but more often, not in the way we expect. The expectations we have of Jesus when he intervenes in our lives are often not what we are looking for. We usually expect Jesus to give us what we want, but Jesus gives us what we need. Jesus did not come to make us happy. He came to make us joyful. And these two words are different, for happiness is a temporary word. It only lasts for a while joy is permanent. It comes from within, no matter the situation in our lives. Jesus did not come to make us feel comfortable. In fact, he came to make us uncomfortable. And we often expect our Lord came to bring peace and harmony, and he did, and he does. But he also came to bring division and a sword. And we often expect Jesus to fulfill all our hopes and dreams and requests, but he came to offer us salvation so that we do not have to experience eternal death. And so Jesus did not come that we may have abundant life on earth, although that's fine if we enjoy that, but he came so that we will have abundant life with him. And many prefer that Jesus would tell us that it is all right to exercise an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But instead, our Lord came and told us to love our enemies, do good to those who hate us, bless those who curse us, pray for those who mistreat us. So if we think that the Jesus we follow came to give us all the things that we would rather have, then we have the wrong Jesus. We have the wrong Jesus. For Jesus came to call us to holiness and from the wrath that is to come, and for us to depend on him. So on this Palm Sunday, and as we begin Holy Week, what are we expecting from Jesus? What are we expecting from Jesus? Jesus invites us to consider the way that he comes in a humble and lowly and peaceful manner. Jesus invites us to realize that the way he shows up in our lives may not be the way we expect. For God usually shows up in unexpected ways. However, if we would only be open to expecting him in unexpected and unusual ways, we will get the opportunity to see him for who he really is. And what incredible lives we could have if only we truly open ourselves to him and to embrace what he has in store for us. Amen.